Good morning, my lovely students. How are you all today? I hope you all are fine and doing well in your studies also. Students, today we will discuss exercise 6.2 and exercise 6.3 of our chapter number 6, fractions. So let's start. The first question of exercise 6.2 A part is write the equivalent fraction of the following. सबसे पहले हमें इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन निकालना है 3/10 का. सो हाउ विल यू फाइंड द इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन? वी जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई द गिवन फ्रैक्शन विद द सेम इन द न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर. इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन के लिए हम क्या करते हैं, हम किसी भी गिवन फ्रैक्शन को सेम नंबर से न्यूमरेटर और डिनोमिनेटर में मल्टीप्लाई कर देते हैं. तो हाउ विल यू राइट 3 × 2? न्यूमरेटर विल एड इन टू न्यूमरेटर and denominator will be added into denominator. So what will be the equivalent fraction? 6/20. Take the another question. Taking fourth one. 3/7 multiplied by 5/5. How will you write? Again you have to write 3 × 5 and 7 × 5. 5 × 3 = 15. And 7 × 5 = 35. The B part of exercise 6.2 is fill the equivalent fraction in the blanks. हमें given blanks में equivalent fractions fill करने हैं. So 14/16. When you reduce 14/16 to the lowest term, that means we have to see the number which can easily and completely divide 14 and 16 at constant. That means it is a number जो 14 और 16 दोनों को divide कर सकता है. हमें वो find करना होता है और हम उससे divide कर देते हैं दोनों number को. हम यहाँ देख सकते हैं 2 is the common number which can divide 14 and 16. So 2 में 7 times आता है 14. So how many times will 16 go in the 2 table of 2? Yes, it is 8. That means we can divide 14/2 and 16/2. We will get 7/8 as a result. This is the second part of B question. Now we will do here the fifth part. 3/7 and 9/blank. Again we can see here how many times 9 will go in the table of 3. 3 × 3 = 9. That means numerator is multiplied by 3. When numerator is multiplied by 3, so we have to make it a equivalent fraction. So we will multiply the denominator also with the 3. हमें denominator को भी 3 से multiply करना होगा to make it a equivalent fraction. Now 9/21 is the equivalent fraction of 3/7. In question number C, we have to find next 4 equivalent fraction of 4/9. हमें यहाँ एक fraction given है 4/9 and हमें इस 4/9 के next 4 equivalent fraction find out करने हैं. So I have told in our previous video, how will you find the equivalent fraction? Just multiply the fraction with the same number in numerator and denominator. जब आप इसे 1 से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे यू विल गेट द सेम आंसर 4/9. नाउ 2 से मल्टीप्लाई जब हम इसे करेंगे इन न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर विल गेट 4 × 2 = 8, 9 × 2 = 18. ओके, व्हेन वी मल्टीप्लाइड इट बाय 3 इन डिनोमिनेटर एंड न्यूमरेटर व्हाट यू विल गेट 4 × 3 = 12 एंड 9 × 3 = 27. इट इज द थर्ड इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन ऑफ 4/9 and we want 2 more, so we will multiply 4 and 5 also. 4 × 4 = 16, 9 × 4 = 36. Similarly, we can multiply it by 5 in numerator and denominator and get the equivalent fraction. 4 × 5 = 20 and 9 × 5 = 45. So 4 next equivalent fraction of 4/9 are 8/18, 12/27, 16/36 and 20/45. Let's take the another question. Question number 3 of C part. This is 1/7. Now When you multiply 1 by 7 by 1, you will get the same answer. So we will start with 2. Multiply 1 by 7 with 2 in numerator and denominator. 2 1s are 2 and 7 2s are 14. Again multiply it by 3. 3 1s are 3 and 7 3s are 21. Multiply it by 4. 4 1s are 4 and 7 4s are 28. And multiply it by 5. 5 1s are 5 and 7 5s are 35. So students, you can see we have got all the 4 next equivalent fraction of 1 by 7. These are 2 by 14, 3 by 21, 4 by 28 and 5 by 35. Okay, now students, in question number D, what we have to do? पार्ट डी में हमें 18 बाई 24 दैट मीन्स गिवन फ्रैक्शन का इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन निकालना है बट वी हैव टू फाइंड इट बाय डिवाइडिंग हमें यहाँ डिवाइड करना होगा सो वी विल सी हेयर विच इज द हाइएस्ट नंबर विच कैन डिवाइड 18 एंड 24 कम्प्लीटली दैट मीन्स हम एक ऐसा नंबर देखेंगे जो 18 और 24 दोनों को डिवाइड कर सकता हो आई मीन यू हैव रेड अबाउट द HCF इन योर प्रीवियस चैप्टर आपने अपने फिफ्थ चैप्टर में हाईएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर के बारे में पढ़ा है सो वी विल सी व्हाट इज द हाईएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर ऑफ 18 एंड 24 एंड देन वी विल डिवाइड 18 एंड 24 फ्रॉम दिस फैक्टर सो फर्स्टली वी विल फाइंड द HCF 18 एंड 24 का जो हाईएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर होगा उसके लिए हमें पहले फैक्टर्स ढूंढने होंगे व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स ऑफ 18 1 2 3 6 9 एंड 18 दीज आर द फैक्टर्स ऑफ 18 एंड व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स ऑफ 24 1 2 3 4 6 8 12 एंड 24 Now students, in both the factors, see the common factors. 1, 2, 3, 6, 1, 2, 3 and 6. As you can see, only 4 factors are common in both the numbers. And which one is the highest? Yes, 6 number is the highest common factor in both. Now, the HCF of 18 and 24 is 6. Now, we will divide 18 and 24 by 6. How will you write? 18 divided by 6 upon 24 divided by 6. When you divide 18 by 6, you will get 3 because 18 comes in the 3 times in the table of 6 and 24 comes 4 times in the table of 6. So, the equivalent fraction by dividing we get 3 by 4 of 18 by 24. Students, now we will discuss exercise 6.3. In exercise 6.3, there are two parts of question. In the first question, we have to reduce the fraction to its lowest term. So, I am doing here A part first question. Question number first is 49 upon 56. Question is, we have to reduce this fraction to the lowest term. हमें इस फ्रैक्शन को लोएस्ट टर्म तक रिड्यूस करना है दैट मीन्स कोई ऐसा नंबर जो 49 और 56 दोनों को डिवाइड कर सकता हो हमें उस फ्रैक्शन में इस नंबर को चेंज करना है सो सिमिलरली इन 6.2 एक्सरसाइज वी हैव सीन व्हाट वी हैव टू डू हमें क्या करना होगा वी हैव टू फाइंड द HCF ऑफ 49 एंड 56 हमें 49 एंड 56 का हाइएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर फाइंड आउट करना होगा Firstly, when you find the highest common factor of 49 and 56, you get the 7. As you can see, 7 is the only number which can divide 49 and 56 completely without leaving a remainder. If you know the table, if you remember tables, agar aapko tables yaad hai, to aapko pata hoga, 49 and 56 is the number which can easily divisible by 7 only. Both the numbers are divisible by 7. So we will take here divide of 49 and 56 by 7. We will write like this. 49 divided by 7 and in denominator 56 divided by 7. will get how many times 49 will go in the table of 7? 7 times. And 56, 7 ki table mein hum kitni baar 56 aayega? 8 times. So, the lowest term of 49 by 56 is 7 by 8. Let's take the another one. I am taking here the fourth one. This is 40 by 72. Again, we have to find out the FCF of 40 and 72. Or you can see the number which can completely divisible, which can completely divide 40 and 72. So, what are the factors of 40? 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 20 and 40. And what are the factors of 72? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, then 12, 12, 6 are 72, then 18, then 36, and then 24, and then 40. 24 is also a factor of 72. So I have written here. Now what are the common factors? 1, 2, after that 8 is also there. Now 40. 40. Okay, sorry, 72 is there, no? 72 will be the last factor. Okay, so common, highest common factor in 40 and 72 is 8. So 8 will be there. Now we will divide 40 and 72 by 8. We'll get how many times 40 will go in 8 table? 5 times. And how many times 72 will go? 8 nines are 72. So what is the lowest term of 40 by 72? Yes, it is 5 by 9. In question number B of exercise 6.3, we have to check that the number, the fraction is in lowest term or not. That means, aapka jo fraction hai, wo already lowest term mein hai ya nahi, hume ye check karna hai. We can see here the common factor of 14 and 18 are 14 ki common factors 1, 2, 7 and 14 are the factors of 14 and 18 ke factors 1, 2, 3, 6, 9 and 18. Now what are the common factors? 1, 2. 2 is the common factor here, which is the highest common factor. So we will divide both the numbers by 2. 14 divided by 2 and 18 divided by 2. We will get 7 by 9. As you can see, 7 by 9 is the lowest term of 14 by 18. So we will write no, because 14 by 18 is not the lowest term. 14 upon 18 lowest term nahi hai. Is fraction ki lowest term hai 7 upon 9. Now see the another one, 6 upon 9. Similarly, hum pehle factors find out karenge. What are the factors of 6? 1, 2, 3 and 6. And factor of 9? 1, 3 and 9. Now find out the common factors. 1 and 3. These are the common factors. So FCF will be 3. Again we have 3 to divide 6 and 9. Again humare paas ek number hai jo 6 aur 9 ko completely divide kar raha hai, which is 3. And what is the lowest term? How many times 6 will come in 3 table? 2 times. And 9 will come 3 times. The lowest term of 6 by 9 is 2 by 3. So easily you can see these are not the lowest term which is given in the question. So simply you will write no. So students, as you can see, exercise 6.2 and 6.3 is very easy. If you will do the sums by yourself, you will be able also to understand the concept and do these exercises in your homework notebook. Till then, goodbye, take care and do your studies well.